Last week's bomb cyclone storm flooded about 60 structures, including 30 buildings at the Offutt Air Force Base, said Ryan Hansen, a spokesman for the 55th Wing, a unit providing reconnaissance, intelligence, and combat support to U.S. leaders. Eight planes in the 55th Wing had to leave the base, Hansen said, and workers might not be able to assess damage to hangars and maintenance buildings until the end of the week. One of the planes was a Boeing-made E-4B plane, one for the Air Force has that are meant to serve as an aerial command center in case of national emergency or destruction of ground bases, such as in a nuclear attack. Two E-4Bs were also damaged by a tornado at Offutt in 2017, CNN reported at the time. Francesco Femia, the co-founder of the Center for Climate and Security, said the flooding shows that the White House needs to let the military do its job in assessing the climate threat. This is an example of a vital threat to our national security from a climate-related disaster, and more of this kind of thing is likely in the future, Femia said. While flooding from storm surges linked to climate change that could damage sensitive electronics and mechanical equipment have long threatened U.S. naval bases like Norfolk, Virginia, Offutt is a reminder that climate change also poses risks to bases far from sea. Offutt is also home to Strategic Command, which oversees the country's nuclear arsenal. The Strategic Command headquarters, set on a hill, was not affected by the floods, and neither was its new building, expected to open in the spring. The White House has considered forming a panel to assess the science used in government climate risk reports that could be headed by a retired physics professor who believes greenhouse gas emissions are good for the planet. The White House did not respond to a request for comment.